shit. So okay. Y'all there. Okay. You just said you was talking about how my mother was late last time. Now y'all there.
Oh, shit. Okay, look. Okay. I was only late because this bitch Kumbyia, okay?
Season 2, LA Hustle. What have you been up to in the past year?
Well, for the past year, y'all, I just been booked. I've been busy. New shows, new albums. New shows, new songs, new performances, new places, new people. You know, I just been popping my shit. But you know, I'm always gonna be on your TV screen. It's T China, baby.
Honestly, I feel like I don't even need an introduction. I've been on TV since the last 14 years. I've already been on some shows on Golf Productions. You probably see me on Zeus. You probably see me on some, a lot of things. But if you haven't seen me, my name is Mason. And, you know, other than reality TV, I also act, I do music, and I model.
I grew up everywhere, California, outside of California, everywhere. So.
Okay, so where did you go to, like, high school at?
I was homeschooled.
You were homeschooled the whole time?
Spoiled.
The whole time?
I'm spoiled. What? I'm the oldest child, but I have, like, only child syndrome. I'm the favorite.
No, I'm the baby, so I got a right to be spoiled.
No.
Okay.
I'm the oldest.
I am the middle. Do I look good? Do I look fat? Do I need to sit up? What? Don't let me be on that camera like that again, please, Lord. That's stupid as fuck. Girl, bye. You already know.
I'm hollering. Jimmy, why'd you do it?
Cross-eyed. I was cross-eyed and shit. What's wrong with that bitch eyes?
Tell my bosses on her eyes. It is recording right now.
Bloopers! Motherfucker. Because I'm fly out all times, bitch.
This is season two, so... LA Hustle season 2, how do you feel?
Wow, I wasn't even gonna be on this shit. Hell no, it was too motherfucking messy. T China and the big ass Mason, y'all know him, was really self absorbed. You know, motherfuckers was like, I'm too old. I'm too what? I guess I was slow like a turtle, right? Whooping ass like a rabbit. Anywho, I wasn't gonna be on this shit because, they motherfuckers was together and they felt like they was together and everybody else was fraudulent. So how I feel about it is, I'm on the show, bitches, because you know what? Kumbaya.
Wait a minute.
Okay. And I'm the oldest.
Well,
the boys. That's why I'm hostile. I'm not bitter. I'm not bitter as a motherfucker, but I'm one of them mama figures.
What do you guys
I was
going
to ask that. Okay, that's not my oldest. I'm a Pisces.
Oh, no.
So I'm vibing out with these two chicks and the camera stopped rolling for a few minutes, and in the midst of all that, Kumbaya, she whispered to me and she's like, you know, be here for Prada and these fake bitches, the other girls, you know, they're really fake and, you know, just watch out for them, they two-faced and all this shit. So I'm like, well, shit, in my head, I'm like, well, once these cameras start rolling, I'm gonna ask them, so who's fake? Cause you know, me, like, what's up? Why you always, for the cameras go down to talk about that? Let's get into it. And let's really get into it. Cause they was getting into it when the cameras was rolling. They was saying a whole lot of shit when the cameras wasn't rolling.
My Pisces game.
Bang, bang.
Bang, bang.
Bang, bang.
Bang,
bang. Bang, bang.
Bang, bang. Bang,
bang.
Off camera, you told Mason, in reference to him going on to film this season to watch his back towards certain cast members.
Not Prada, but. Did she say Prada? She might have said Prada.
I don't know. She, you know.
He's a,
but,
I don't know.
Did you tell Mason that off camera? And what was that about?
Well, you know, I was just trying to put him up on game how silly these other females was. They were silly, but they was prosperous. You know, all these females that, you know, that we've been talking about, is good in their own lane, but they not here for this. They wasn't here for this. So I just said, watch out. But I just learned that, you know, I guess we ain't all here for this. I don't know what the fuck.
Yes.
So you already know.
A fish out of water. Put us in some motherfucking water.
The vibe's kind of cool, but it's giving a little. You want to know me too much. Like, chill, baby, chill. We good.
Let us swim.
Seriously. Those things that you say to my big people.
So how are you guys feeling?
Tishana's acting so clueless right now, and in the mental, I'm like, okay, I already know what type of person you are. You got a big mouth, but you're not the type to even say it to the person's face or admit to it.
Show up on time. Be about it like I always. I'm telling you.
Honestly, just make sure you believe in the project that you're doing.
So, you know, I'm just kind of giving him the rundown with our producer, how I work over here at Golf Television, you know. Since day one, I've been here. So, I just wanted to let you know, no tea, no shade. Just be aware of a couple of people, you know. Certain people fall out. Certain people don't want to show up to film. Certain people act like they're too busy and stuff like that. So, you know, don't take it personal.
And
God will finish the rest.
And
like,
I feel like
that's just how I feel.
LA Hustle could have been more better if we had more productive. I think everybody in LA Hustle, not to even say nothing about y'all Bronx. I love y'all.
No shade.
But if no shade. But if y'all would have brung it, we wouldn't be like comparing. There's no comparison. Right now, I already know that y'all gonna bring it because y'all already seen our mistakes.
So they're sitting here giving me advice on how I need to move around, but honestly, I've already been on TV way before them, so I'm gonna move however the fuck I want to move and do whatever I want to do, and that's just that.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Oh my gosh.
Hi.
Yes.
Hi, I love your hair.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, how are you guys?
Boom, bitch, it's me, it's Prada, a lot of water, a lot of dollars. I am motherfucking back with the new titties. Yeah, everybody was talking that shit, saying I had a boy body and shit. Yeah, it's all them jokes is up. They're up, okay? So, anyway, I've been doing my music. I've been, you know what I'm saying, popping bottles in the section, been meeting people, been getting interviews. I've been dropping music and... Yeah, I've been talking more since everybody say I don't talk too much.
I'm like the room. This is like this
I actually got this for you.
Thank you.
This is from my skincare.
Okay.
Yes.
Period.
Yeah, and I'm like, what's
your name? All for you. Moisturizer, fragrance.
You're not sharing something with me.
I was literally just like fixing up myself, so this is perfect.
Yeah, perfect. You're gonna be looking good and smelling good with all that stuff.
I love it. I love to smell good though.
Okay, right. Welcome to motherfucking Vegas.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we in Vegas and I done got an Airbnb right by the strip. So I invited Mason, Jimmy, and Maurice over. So we about to talk about some shit.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm glad you came.
Oh, no, right?
Oh, it's about to be lit. But yes. Before we go out, I'm not gonna lie. I'm a straight to the point kind of person. You know what I mean? So tonight I'm meeting up with Prada, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm uber excited to even spill the tea to her about what these hoes was saying, because I'm Messy Mason. I'm here to stir the pot. You feel me? So the other day, me and my bro, we linked up with Kumbyia, we linked up with Team China, and I saw y'all season. It was lit. I had to say something to motherfucking Team China. She came late, you know what I mean? I'm like, girl, you can't come to my set late, you know what I mean? Like,
you was talking about how other people late.
You know, my shit late. Like, what's going on?
Exactly.
But in the process of all that, they were saying shit about fake bitches and watch your back, and I'm like... I know the LA Hustle's coming, you know what I mean? I knew y'all was gonna come, I had a feeling. So I'm like, well, what's going on? But they didn't want to give me no information. So I'm like, hey, Prada's in the building. I know Prada's the number one. You a real one. You know what I mean? So I know if I come to you, ask you something, you're gonna tell me straight up. So what's going on with the
Well, they messy as fuck. How about that? How about I put an at name on that? Okay. Oh, yeah. So they're all fucking messy as hell. So like, he was just talking about how fake bitches and this and that, and I'm just like, well, are they talking about themselves? Yeah, they saying watch your back. They warning you about them. That's what they say. Ooh. That's why they didn't say no names, because right. they wanted to warn you about them.
They didn't want to tell themselves.
They don't want to tell themselves and right, shit like that. They talk shit and then they won't back that shit up.
Right.
You feel Ooh. Me? So they didn't want to say no names because they probably didn't see what the fuck happened to people saying my name. I just, you know, finished on the sentence because people can't say names on here and stuff like that. Like they were saying my name last season. They can't say it this season because I slammed somebody last season.
I see what happens when they say your name too. Your name be buzzing in the streets of LA and everybody people it's know.
We're not talking about the designer now.
We ain't talking about the designer. Right. We talking about the bad bitch that box. You know what? I'm not gonna lie. When Prada ran that back to me, I was like, she's on to something. I don't think she's lying. So I'm about to go kick it with these bitches a little bit and I'm gonna investigate. And truth be told, I don't even know why these hoes even told me anything. Because of course I'm gonna run back and tell Prada everything. Yeah, T-China, you messy, but I'm messier. That bitch be a beat your ass.
Oh, like a butterfly sting, like a
bee. Like a bee, okay? She from where Muhammad Ali's from.
Nah, but for real, like that's a whole nother story, and like they just didn't want to tell them themselves though. Like they be trying to pick and choose who they want to pick with and shit. Right. That's not cool. Like that shit foul as fuck. But fuck them.
Hey, you know what? Right.
I'm here, name.
We is lit.
The fuck.
You know what I mean? We about to turn the fuck up tonight.
And
I'm gonna take your word, cause you, from what I seen, you always been real. You know what I mean? And when I asked you a question, you gave me something. You know, I really like Prada. I loved her on season one. She's one of my favorites. So I'm glad that she's one of those people that when you meet them, they still cool in real life. Like she's super down to earth and she's just real.
I'm not gonna keep it just 100. I'm gonna keep it above 50 with you.
That part, you keep it at that over 1,000. You know what I mean?
Yay, you guys, so finally, after all this planning, all this money, all this saving, you know, I'm throwing my daughter her birthday party, you know, and we're gonna do it great, and all of her family's here, and my sister stays out here in Vegas, so it's really great for me to be able to come and have my nephew and all the family together. I'm enjoying it, I love it.
Well, it's
that
NIDA, and they wrote it right.
I know.
I was proud, I was happy.
So, you know, I got my mom out here. I got my sister out here. They looking great. We all looking like a unit. I was really happy how it turned out. I also invited Mez, you know, from Bosses on the Rise. If you don't know, but now you do. And Kayla as well. And we all had a good time. We, you know, money wasn't a problem. All right, it's so So everyone's singing happy birthday. We all had a great time, you know, and it just warms my heart to see my princess having the time of her life with all her cousins.
Hey, about to leave, baby. Oh, thank you. I love you. Thank you for coming, guys. Y'all so much like family. Thank y'all for coming out and showing love.
Definitely. We always only link up, period. Every time we're in Vegas. Anytime. I love y'all.
Let's get out of here.
Southside.
T-Fly.
It's only one way I know how to describe this shit.
Email.
What's it on that beat? Nah. We gon' make sex sounds.
So it's a nice Ching party, period. We lit up in this bitch. So we over here popping it, popping bottles, shit. We partying, we getting lit in this motherfucker. And you know, I seen a bitch that owe me some money in that motherfucker.
Okay, wait a minute.
So, you know what I'm saying? I ended up performing my song, and you bitches acting funny, and your coochie ain't making no money. So, yeah, I had to play that song real quick for the bitch and for everybody in the building, and it was lit as fuck. Everybody was twerking, people was lit, and shit, it was popping.
Your coochie ain't making no money.
And Ching, I love you. You look beautiful as fuck. Bitch, we was twinning lightweight. So, yeah. Yeah, all that.
Oh, we gon' do it for the culture. Ay, we gon' do it for the culture. Ay, we gon' do it for the... Not just drop for flashy things, but she gon' drop that for me.
Now, I told y'all I was about to go investigate. Look at me hang out with this bitch. Talking about she need help looking for a music video. Alright, I'm down.
Oh my gosh, it's been like a minute since I seen you since Judge Mathis.
We killed that show. So I'm meeting up with Mason. After Vegas, we've actually been hitting off like really good. You know, we've been kind of hanging out damn near every day. You know, picking up, taking it everywhere, you know, shit like that. And right now, we just gonna chill at the park, kind of catch up. Like, you know, I just did Bosses on the Rise. I do want to talk to him about a couple of things that went down there. And he came and made a cameo. So I want to see how he felt a little bit.
I know all the bloggers right now, they're definitely talking about
it.
It
was all over the blogs.
Yeah, literally.
I was like, oh, they caught us with that this.
Y'all know it's, you know me. You see me.
It was lit. So I brought this bitch on Judge Mathis. You know, I do shit like this all the time.
Defendant Adela Daniels met the plaintiff on a reality show, and they collaborated on some music together. But he's suing because she failed to pay her portion for two recording sessions.
I loved it, like seriously. But Chicago all over though, like she was just.
I love Chicago. I have fun suing you. I have fun going out there making some money.
I had fun talking my little shit, pop my shit to you, period. Met him on my side.
Yeah.
I was lucky upset, dude. Like I, you know, the extra part.
At the end, he was talking mad shit.
He was,
but it was. was cool.
It was so much fun though. I think like people really expected us to be mad at each other. I like one of the bloggers be like, oh my god, are you guys like, still mad at each other?
Friend, right?
Are you guys still not friends?
It's like crazy.
We'll always be best friends, okay?
Always be best friends.
Get that shit together,
know?
Okay? Understand it.
So I didn't go, but I had some heads in the building, you know what I mean? I heard you didn't go to Ching Ching party. What happened? Because I know you two were on Boston the Rise. I thought y'all was pretty close.
No, yeah. Like, I definitely love Ching. You feel me? She's a great person. Like, she's super sweet. She always about her money. That's my baby. But I just don't always rock with everybody. She rock with. And I heard certain heads was going in. And I was like, I'm good on the drama. And on top of that, I had to work. So, money first, baby.
I feel you.
So, honestly, I'm talking to Mason. I'm letting him know why I didn't really feel comfortable about going to Ching Ching's party. You know, there's a couple things that went down on Bosses on the Rise where she felt like she needed to confront me. And I kind of wasn't feeling it. Like, you know, I'm the type of person, you could just talk to me, sis. You feel me? And then on top of that, out of nowhere, I hear Prada has a problem with me because Mason's friends with me. And I'm like, wait, Prada, aren't we friends? So what's the problem? But then I heard she was gonna be at the party too, and I was like, yeah, I don't need the drama. I'm good.
I just wasn't really feeling it. You know, that whole situation on the set of Boston the Rise in the garage, you know what I mean? When she put us to the side, was just popping her shit. So I was like, you know, Minnie did ask me, she's like, gonna come, and I was like, I'm not really feeling that kind of vibe, you know what I mean? Just because that's the last time I've really seen her.
Yeah, you know? I know. That was crazy as hell. Like, being in the garage, I just felt like we had to defend ourselves. Like, we were put in a corner, low-key.
Yeah,
and okay, I didn't like that. And especially coming from Ching, I'm like, girl, what? Like, but you know, I don't know. Maybe it was the party, maybe it was, you know, a little stuff going around.
You know what I mean?
Really?
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. But maybe it was the party. Maybe it was the party.
Okay. Maybe people just got ahead of themselves at the party. Because, you know, that's also the time where I have fought Yaya. So, I think a lot of people got besides themselves that night. If I do say so, my motherfucking self. I feel like I'm getting to a different level in this industry, and I need to present myself accordingly.
Yeah. She's going to be on season 2.
And the fact that she's not friends with you because you're friends with me.
Yeah. What the fuck is poppin'?
Oh, my nigga. You need to shake my hand before we even have this altercation. You know what? I already knew that you was a motherfucking devil. You told me.
A devil see a devil.
You told me. Exactly.
I like your yarn. That's cute. The hair, the arms, that's cute.
I got blocked on Instagram?
Yeah. You know I'll fuck with. I don't even want to say her name. I don't even want to say Gloria's name. That's what her name is. You know, man, I got to start Gloria.
Oh my gosh.
I'm not a fan of T-China. I'm a fan of Gloria. That's you,
oh,
bitch.
Oh, I'm Gloria, right?
Why you laughing?
Because that's funny as shit.
Like I said, whatever I say once, I can say motherfucking twice. No, you said I'm gonna fight you
because
you old.
No, I will fight you if you come at me.
Okay.
Girl, so what? Minnie says she got the best of you, bitch.
She says she whooped your ass.
Okay. Watching and fucking fighting.
Okay, well.
Why can't you? You can't fight home!
Talking about. wasn't with no, beef with nobody.
Right.
I don't like neither one of you have home eating ass bitches.
When you go to sleep, wake up in the morning. If you still feel like you need that, then do that. But right now, it's over. We're gonna get put out this house.
I sat here and was right there. That's the only reason why I know who the fuck wrote your name out, my nigga.
I'm giving you confrontation before confrontation. Okay. So why right now?
Okay.
So why right now? But I can't tell you.
You don't come in my house and I talk to me or my sisters, bitch. If you don't want your one, like, excuse me, I'm done. Fuck!
What the bitch?
I'm not a bitch, Jimmy. I'm not a bitch.